Hey guys, welcome to Dakes Gaming, where today we are going to go over a build video designed to break away from needing help and carries while progressing through the challenge tiers. This build is viable for CT 1 to 15, and you could very well use this as a main build in CT 15 too, as I've tested it, and honestly, it shreds. And yes, you heard me, this is a viable option in CT 15 too, plus it is effortless to use, which is probably another reason why I like it so much, as sometimes I just want to sit back and chill. In my opinion, this is the perfect starting point for any new player or an experienced player looking for a laid-back approach. So before we go further, over 90% of people watching are not subscribed. Dropping a sub to my channel helps more than you know, and I appreciate each and every one of you. To those of you who are already subbed, thank you, you're amazing. To add further motivation to those of you watching this video, I've put together a giveaway which you can win a £25 or dollar gift card. There are three options to choose from: PlayStation, Xbox, and Google Play. I will then contact the winner and discuss what type of gift is preferred when the competition ends on the 31st of July, and the winner will then be announced on the 1st of August. All the information is in the description, so take a look and get involved. I do need to tell you that even though this is aimed at beginners, perhaps you are not new to the game, but you are still missing a key piece of armor. You will need to farm some Monster Hunt seasons from Noah, and possibly even use the exploit to save time when trying to obtain these items, because, as we all know, cannonball gear is really common. They are the Trespasser helmet and the legs. These two armor pieces are essential to the build because of the perks that they offer. You can opt to get the Trespasser gloves, but the cannonball gauntlets would be a better choice in my opinion. Everything else needs to be focused on firepower, cooldown reduction, close range damage, and have some sort of mod you'd find useful on them. Let me show you what I have on mine, and then you can either go farm something which is your preferred choice, or you can go and look for something similar to what I have. The choice is yours. So let's get into the armor and mods. Please note that these are for beginner level, and you can incorporate other mods if you have them to improve on the build. So on the helmet, I have stare into the barrel and long range. The bonus firepower, close range damage, and cooldown reduction complement this nicely. On the chest, we've got a pointless mod, so this could be changed out with an epic armor if you wanted. Alternatively, you could use the set if you have it and run Slow Trap instead of Hunt the Prey, but in my opinion, Hunt the Prey is better. Vampiric Mag is the important mod, which really makes this build tick. On the legs, we've got the Tier 3 mod, where if an enemy is affected by the skill, you don't consume ammo. I can't even stress how good this is if paired with double time, because you've got an enemy floating in the air doing nothing to you for 7 seconds, and you can just hold the button down and destroy it with back shots. Cannonball gauntlets are just a staple of mine. I use them for almost everything. They have bonus firepower, cooldown reduction, and skills life leech, plus some great mods for damage dealing. Then you'll just want to find a decent pair of epic boots, which has bonus firepower, cooldown reduction, and close range damage. Weapon wise, if you have one, use the bulwark. You can find these through doing bounties, and I would advise using Killing Spree or Dark Sacrifice on it in addition to the ultimate bleeding bullets, and then level it up as you go along. However, if you don't want to look for one, there is a budget solution. Skip this section if you don't want to learn about the budget option. It's aimed at new players that don't have any mods. Okay, so this next part is going to be a little bit complicated. What you need to do is buy an automatic shotgun with any of the following: close range damage, status power, critical damage, or weapon life leech. Increase the rarity of the gun and get a mod like Critical Point, Death Chains, Storm Whip with the weapon. This will be a god roll basically. If you increase the rarity and are still in the section where you select a mod and you don't like it, dashboard the game until you get a roll you want. It just means that you're not going to be constantly wasting resources and time trying to get a perfect roll. Ideally, you'll have the Amber Vault, which is easily obtainable through some help from the community. I'd strongly advise getting involved with Facebook or Discord groups, the legit ones of course, and asking for help to farm the last boss for weapons until you get the Amber Vault. If you have the Fatal Symbiont, you can break this down for the Dark Sacrifice mod, which is highly regarded, but harder to find, and available through the bounties. Going back to Killing Spree, it is the easiest to get, as people can help you get the mod should you not have Dark Sacrifice. Then to make it really OP, you're going to go to talk to Dr. Zahidi, swap out the mod you don't want with Perpetuum Mobile, pay for it, then change to a mod such as Killing Spree and pay for it. You'll get the use of Perpetuum Mobile even though it isn't on the weapon, and you'll also get the ability to deal an extra 75% damage which will destroy. Just to clarify, Perpetuum Mobile refills the mag when you get a kill with less than 35% ammo in the clip. This would then pair with an armor mod called Vein Ripper, where on critical hits you inflict bleed, and then that will activate the Vampiric Mag perk, where you'll get 50% of your ammo refunded on a kill where the enemy is affected by bleed. Now, I know this is a lot of information, so in the description I will have more information for telling you exactly what you need to know, but in bullet points, just in case you need it. Next, we are going to look at the skills used and the skill tree. The build is focused on Time Rift, Twisted Rounds, and Hunt the Prey. These are quite standard for me, especially in this order, as you will not be activating Twisted Rounds too much if you play the correct method. You will probably only really use the skill after cutscenes and or if you're extremely unlucky and run out of ammo, which is pretty hard to do with this build. I didn't really change anything from my standard build as it wasn't necessary. However, you will want to ensure you get the deception cooldown as it is more important than the movement cooldown. Feel free to pause the video and copy the skill tree. Basically, in summary, it focuses on weapon damage and cooldown reduction, while giving boosts when using deception and movement skills. If you use those skills, you'll get a 70% bonus damage increase for 8 seconds, so if you're chaining it non-stop, that is a permanent 70% damage buff. So you're probably wanting to get into the thick of it now, and see exactly what you need to do. Really, it is quite simple. All you need to do is try and group up as many enemies as you can together, use Time Rift, use your movement skill, and go nuts. You'll activate your 70% damage buff for 8 seconds, and during that time, you can reuse the skills to keep that damage up. Using Time Rift on bosses is often quite frustrating, as they deflect the skill, but when it does affect the boss, teleport behind it and you'll kill it super easy. Just hold the trigger down and you should easily finish it off in seconds, while not running out of ammo due to the armor mod we mentioned previously, where when the enemy is affected by Time Rift, no ammo is consumed. I just want to point out that there are other videos that I have done on builds which you may find useful. I am covering builds in great detail now, and I'm sure that if you take a look through my channel, you'll find one that works for you. Thanks for watching the video, hopefully it has helped you. Maybe you can recommend this video to a friend just starting out on Outriders, or to someone that wants to do what I've showcased here today. So if you found the video helpful, like it, share it with your friends, and if you want to support me, a sub is always welcomed and appreciated. Have a fantastic day, and I'll catch you on the next one.